Another one.
I don't know if you could take it. No, you wanna see me naked, naked, naked. I wanna be a baby, baby, baby. Spinning in his red just like he came from Maytag. Rock a whistle on the brown. Like, when I get like this, I can't be around you. I'm too lit to dim down the night. Cause I can name some things that I'm gon' do. Wow, wow.
Starting this year off right. Hey guys, it's Shade of the Universe. I am back with another video. Let me start off by saying that, like, sorry that my bra and panties don't match. Like, they're like close, but I had to make this separately from the underwear just so you know you guys won't be seeing all this. But it looks better, way better naked, of course, because it's lingerie and it's supposed to look better naked. But yeah, this is like super simple and easy to make, and it's cheaper. All the materials that I have linked down below, it's way cheaper to just like make it, and you can customize it way more if you want to do different colors. I was originally gonna do the long romper, like the jumpsuit, but I already have pants that I made before, lingerie pants, on my channel, so I wanted to do something different. But if you're interested in making this super cute, sexy, fun, flirty romper, just keep watching.
So for this romper, you'll need 2 yards of lavender mesh fabric, matching thread, lavender elastic, and 2 lavender feather boas. And do you see how beautiful this boa is? Oh my god. I'll definitely be linking all the materials down below. So first, get a tank top and a pair of loose fitted shorts. If you have a strapless romper, more power to you. Tuck in the shirt and mark where the top and your shorts meet on your tank top. Lay it on some paper and trace around it to make your pattern. You see me with a ruler, but you really don't need to add any seam allowance because this fabric is very stretchy. Cut out the pattern and place it on your fabric. Make sure that the fabric is folded and then folded again for a total of 4 layers. Cut around the pattern and unfold. And behold my fuck up. I went back and realized to not cut the front edge. I was really confused at first to why it looked like this. And then I went back and realized to not cut the front edge off, or you'll have a huge slit down the front, and that is just not the look we're going for. So I had to go back and recut. But when you cut it, just don't cut the front part off. Now just pin the sides together. I folded them over so it'll be easier to sew, and then sew it with a straight stitch. Once that's done, sew the crotch area together, folding the edge over as well. Now mark where the top of your shorts end and fold in 1 layer of fabric to make a faux seam. Sew with a straight stitch and then repeat for the back as well. This is what it looks like after. Next, take your elastic band and wrap it around your waist. Stretch it to where it's a little snug and cut at that point. Then sew the elastic together with a zigzag stitch. Where those middle seams end, pin your elastic around the waist and then sew with a zigzag stitch. Make sure to pull on it gently all the way around so it can fit. Be sure to go slow because this definitely takes some time and I had to practice this. After that is done, hem the top of the romper with a straight stitch. So this is what it looks like at this point. The original has buttons on the side for easy access, but we just not going to be doing all that. We're going to fold in the extra fabric under the arms and attach a Velcro strip to each side like you see here. It comes with adhesive, but hot gluing it makes it last a lot longer. Next, measure where the top and back start for your straps. Mine is 22 inches, so I'm going to cut my straps at 11 inches because elastic stretches, you know. Pin onto the front and back, making sure that they both line up, and sew with a zigzag stitch. So at this point, my shorts were too long, and I am such a scissor happy bitch. I had to fold it in. I had to look in the mirror and fold to fabric to where I thought was good enough to cut because I refuse to mess this up like I already messed up the first time. Then I cut both sides at an angle. And then on to everyone's favorite part, gluing on the boa. Make sure your Velcro strips are closed because you don't want to glue over them. And full warning, this gets messy and really hot. It will burn you because the glue will go right through the mesh onto your hands. Ideally, maybe you should use E6000 glue. No, actually, definitely use E6000 glue. I just didn't have any more, but yeah, so I ended up burning my hands for this. Once you glue the boa all around at the top and bottom, you are done. And this is what it looks like. This was so easy to make and probably took maybe not even an hour. And the best thing about this is that you can customize it to your liking. You can get any color that you want at this point. Green, yellow, pink, purple, any color that Rihanna doesn't sell, so you can just make it that much better.
And that is it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you're interested in other lingerie items that I made, I'll have a playlist that's linked down below. I've made pants, a dress, socks, hell, I made like sexy looking socks, so I'll have that link below. And if you are trying to see more of me, I'll see you in my next video. Bye.